everyone on today, the 20th of November 2017, and I'm just running the video here, video there, and also the video here.
Oh, you want to sit over there?
No, I'm going to go here. I'm just running these videos.
Okay.
That one's flicking at the moment.
Well, you're going to send a clip in to cut over here.
I will do that with me afterwards. I'm going to make sure I know.
How long are we going to fund service for?
Just Karakia.
Yeah. We stamp the book, the two pages that need to be done to place the books.
Oh, no, I have to come.
So that should take about what?
So we can continue now.
Yeah.
chief, Hoori, Kuri. We've had the Hoori at Tahiti Marae, and we're marking this in history as a point of settlement of British Royal Navy in Whirinaki, Russell and Busby, as pertaining to the Treaty of Waitangi signing here of the 75 or so chiefs. As origination from Admiralty and this flag that the King has given us, King William IV, to mark our connection to Britain directly in the Hokianga Harbour as a first port of call in anything legal connected to a native court, which is in Tahiti, that we have marked down in history as the native magistrate court opening directly to Edinburgh Magistrate Court and Westminster Magistrate Court. So I'm saying, as my Wairoa family and the Rogan family, Dick Rogan, Pika Rogan, and the Raiti Wairoa on the Maranaro rocks at Te Aroha, was responsible with these native land titles in the Rangitukia Magistrate Court, connected to Tahiti Native Magistrate Court and connected to Hokianga Native Magistrate Court in Russell Bay of Islands, or better known as Russell Township, of the Royal British Navy. Entrance from here in the Hokianga Harbour first, and then over to Hokianga to set up the Magistrate Court there. They had difficulty in Honeheke with cutting their flag down, and so they shifted to Aotearoa Magistrate Court in Helenville, where Rogan married the Manahi family, and John Rogan, the grandfather of Mohi Tamaki Manukau IV. So I have all his history, which led me to investigate his history, my own history with Rogan, of Rogan judges married into my family at the East Coast and married into the Manukau family, John Rogan, joined together. That's why I'm here as a native land commissioner to verify the records of Hoori Te Kuri as being a prominent chief of Ngāpuhi, and with the Ngāpuhi district in Kaikohe, linked in a 360 degree area. And I've invited with Morris Baker to all the descendants of Hoori Te Kuri to come to the Hoori. So from that we have made law with this in mind for the first arrivals of the British settlers, in particular the Russell family, Moira Hoffman Russell, a friend of mine, Moira, and her family Russell were here in the Whirinaki lower area of the land in settlement with Busby. So I had her to witness for me her side of the British arrivals here and Rauni, and the port, and here where the treaty was signed. So we are putting this record straight, that the memorial of Hoori Te Kuri is positioned on the top of the Maunga, above the Marae, as being the highest point lookout from as far as the eye could see. And I say this, that his territory is Ngāpuhi and joined to up north and right down to Taupō, is that northern province of called Auckland, with these magistrates' courts inside it that I've just mentioned, and with Te Rau Waikato Whare Here Here Manukau, Paramount Chief, and also Hongi Heka, Paramount Chief from north at Te Hutu at Ika Marae. I've opened up the native court there and opened up the Hokianga Native Court and took that over to the Waitangi Marae and opened inside the Marae with Tingi Taurua Hoori Paper and Hoheva Epiha as a native magistrate court in its original form, with the ship of Admiralty on the dry land as being the highest court in our country and projected out to the world with this flag to travel the four corners of the earth with an 8-point star of St. Patrick inside this jurisdiction of law that we are putting on the record today from this mariah, this church. And also, I have scribed the marks, the lines, to line up on top of the hill with a video to show the church here, and where the tree was signed, a point marking that to the Ratana church where Morris is looking after the land. And I'm staying there presently as the Ratana, T.W. Ratana, with his plaque on top of the hill in the Urupa, identified the Urupa as where the positioning of mana lies in Ngāpuhi, as to the mana lying in Afitu with Lefa Manakau on his books, these title books here that we're listening today, with Lefa Lefa and Rogu signed in a deed titled Receipt as proof that there was a connection between us and Britain, two-party private contract, and anything else was third-party. So I'm identifying the Manakau title as being customary before it got cut up, and with the survey SO number on the titles, on the big blocks, and with Referefa there and Hoori to here, in this area is no different in its authority and its certificate to all those land lots inside the New South Wales and the New Zealand government, Crown, Queen Victoria and Queen Elizabeth, third party contract here today, putting on the record as being this is where the Treaty of Waitangi was signed for those documents on the Queen, Victoria and Queen Elizabeth's side in Waitangi Marae and Titi Marae, as being secondary to this piece of land here, as one piece of land to all the rest of the pieces of land of New Zealand. And those two chiefs, as two prominent chiefs, one Moriori, Manakau title, and one Ngāpuhi Tahiti Cook Island title. That's going to Hongiheka and Te Rau Waikato, what I had here in Manukau, on the stamps we have here to authenticate these documents with a joining of the two today here, and we will authenticate with Manahi, Parapara Mauheni, as being a direct descendant of Manukau, Te Rau Waikato, Wharehere in Manukau, with King George, 1820 to 1830 period of a private contract that set the pattern off to lock these lands as a blueprint for the rest of the native countries in the world in that period of time, and locked with King William IV and Referefa Manukau on this contract here in our time, in our period of commerce, and the King of Commerce or the King of the Sea. And this flag here you see as being the contract of 1834, the 15th of March 1834, Okeaka Native Magistrate Court in Russell, where that British title was stamped into history here, has been overlooked, and the New South Wales took over from there as being secondary on the 1835 Declaration of Independence and leading to the 1840 treaty signed here. So the authority, as far as I'm concerned, as a native land commissioner, is to verify that this is the piece of land that the Treaty of Waitangi was signed by the 75 or so chiefs, to authenticate these documents back to them and back to Hoori Te Kuri on the top of the hill as a paramount chief with the same likeness of documents as Referefa Manukau of Afitu in the south of Manukau Harbour. That's to Cambridge University in Britain, where he and Hongiheka went to learn English, and Hongiheka was responsible for the security of the investment interests of this flag and its titles to commerce, trade, in the sea, around the whole world, with our native title locked in the contract so that it would not be pirated. This is a pirate flag to keep pirates out. And so we are still in the contract today, and we are just reasserting our sovereign powers and our authority of the king. I'm acting as surrogate king, William IV, for this flag, speak for the king, and until there's a king put into Westminster. Now, I'm saying this for the record that King Ernest Augustus, the fifth, is the reigning monarch of Britain, UK, Hanover, and Aotea, New Zealand, Pacific Islands. As far as we're concerned, we have done that in Te Timorai and Waitangi. Put him as our oath of office, though he's not there. He has been the only king that's incumbent of the king-to-king title in sailor law forbids women from sati. But the queen has her own title. She has gone to EU Parliament and is abandoned ship and left her married people afloat to sort themselves out. So this is the way to sort the Maori side of the 1835 flag, or the other half of this flag, and the 1840 treaty, which we can now report to Britain from here with the blessings of this church and our minister, Mauheni, to officiate and authenticate these documents before I go to Westminster with Morris or Lobo, as his name is called, Morris Baker or Pecker, and his wife, Marianne, to assist myself and Manahi to take this discovery of home back to identify ourselves in the flag. And they will recognize their British settlement here as authentic to all native countries in the world. And we are just putting the record straight for Ngāpuhi, because they went to get help from Britain, but it's turned the other way into the Queen and the Rothschild banks took it and it went that way. So we're putting it back into the King's Bench Court, which we operate now at the moment. Inside Tahiti Marae is now a native magistrate court, Britain direct. So with that, I just want to say from our Rangitukia area, one more final point is that the St. Mary's Church is 1831, where the births, deaths, and marriages of the British fathers were put together as a blueprint for all the other births, deaths, and marriages certificates in the world through King William IV in New York on the Stock Exchange. So I'll just briefly say that that's where it came from on my land blocks in the Rahui Marae, Tiki Tiki, and the Rangitukia Native Magistrate Court was a schoolhouse there where these documents were signed with Clendon, James Reddy Clendon, captain of his Admiralty ship, British ship, when signed here at Okeaka Native Magistrate Court in the Auckland provincial area of described from north Te Reo Wairua or Cape Reina down to south of Taupo in a line east to west. All of that area was the province of Auckland at this time these contracts were made. So that's the part of the birth certificates and the fashioning of titles and instruments over the land. The land is still there, but I'm talking about documents that created the wealth that they enjoy and that we have not yet. But we are still two-party contract with the British direct, and everything else is third party. I'm saying here, for the record, that the mana lies here on this piece of land. Te Timorai and Waitangi Marae is a third party with a New South Wales. St. Patrick, comes from Belfast, Ireland, Protestant Church. My Roman family comes from there as judges here in Aotearoa, Native Court in Helensville, and Mauheni Tamaki Manukau, where I started the research with his whakapapa and then ended up on my own at home to escape those instruments and the St. Patrick's Church in Belfast. Downpatrick Village County is what formed the birth, death, marriage certificates and all the other certificates to collect the royal revenue for these kings from the councils and fashioned as rates and administrative costs and everything of prized possessions comes under this 8-point star. You'll see John Key wearing it here just recently, and I'm wearing it on my hat, and anybody else that's a sheriff in these courts have the authority. It's for you people watching around the world to decide which is authentic. And I'm saying we're going back to Britain to take our authentic findings today. After today, we have a meeting in where the Manukau title is put inside that marae to this marae here, and join Ngāpui with the Moriori and the Tahiti, and they are one. That's the way to bring all the people together, is to identify who we are and where we come from. And that includes Pākehā and everybody. Once and for all, we'll put the history in its right place where it should be, and it should turn out, as far as I'm concerned, it should turn out exactly right. So with that, I'm saying that with those St. Mary's Church, St. Patrick's Church, and our King, with the flag he gave us to protect that business, and it goes on, it's not cut, we have to go to Britain to either extend it or replace the trustees, the Queen, and Andrew, and the King and Queen of Spain. The King has died of Spain and left the Queen of Spain, and their son, Philippe, King Philippe, took over from his father, but not the trust. The trust belongs to us, the Queen Victoria Trust, 1848, still belongs to us, so we have to identify ourselves with any sort of claim to that. So I'm just saying, the book here is a magistrate court portable to be on any marae in the world, or any marae in New Zealand, Pacific Islands, and in any court in the world is tax precedence, because it's a king's court, and the king has put all these laws in fashion and designed all the acts of commerce and of everything that has somewhat like a judge and somewhat like a lawyer. In fact, that's what I do. There's my part of the blood in me, and the brain foul part is tied to Moai from East Island to Kito, the birth of the world on East Island to Kito, at the East Gate on our Marangaro box, where this magistrate court was. That is why the Roman married the Wanawa and married the Manukau, for that reason of these documents of two families to make it get this far. So with that Manahi, I just wanted to acknowledge that Rāmeka was living and practicing the church with the Wesleyan church in Whiriraki with the Russell family. My good friend Moira Hoffman, German, Russell, English, is living here at that time in Rāmeka and in that valley there. And the Russell is the Manahi families, one of the Manahi families, went to Russell. That's her name in Russell. And she'll verify her side of these authentic documents at any stage to put the record right of her arrival, of her British people. And so that's all I want to say today. It's all yours from now, Manahi. Thank you for the opportunity to witness with you today.
Thank you.
kato aroha noa. Pai here tia e terangi Māori e nā wā katoa, koe anō rā te māua e he tautoko mai. Ae me ake me ae. I've got a few documents to sign come up. And if there's any questions, I'm going to ask Hoori. I just for kumuti tō tātou.
There's only three or four documents to sign. No, he didn't even phone. Doesn't ring direct.
Hey?
No, I'm whistling.
Oh.
So, bit big cheek on me. You've got three phones, give me one. Three phones.
Years ago.
Six, 7 years ago. Yes, so it's my